Hello, my lovely Scorpio. How are you, loves? I hope everybody is well. Scorpio, welcome to your weekly reading, weekly energies, second week in January, the week we are moving into Mercury retrograde. So be more careful, loves, as well. There might be coming up any delays over there. Try to plan ahead. Because that's how is the Mercury retrograde. It's bringing certain delays, but sometimes Mercury retrograde brings certain energies that you can reflect on, readjust, relearn, review everything with re. And for some of you, there is people who might come around you that are part of your past. Could be an ex, not necessary, could be people that you didn't speak for a long time. It's feeling like, whoa, wow, this person contact me, I didn't see them since high school. Yes, that speaks about Mercury retrograde. Let's see here, Scorpio, what do we have for you and how the things are going for this week? How is your energy? And what are those messages the spirit sends to you? It seems to me that for many, many Scorpios, it's a great week. Joy. Joy is the highest energy of all. It's the magical sense that everything is possible. Joy springs from approaching the gifts with each moment. Joy allows you to attract and create your present and future moment at their highest possible levels. And underneath here, we have steady progress. We acknowledge you for the progress you've made in remembering love in your daily activity. We can clearly see the contribution you are making to the world through your thoughts, feelings, and actions of love. So, whatever you are right now, one step at a time being made. It's kind of like brick by brick, you work through. And I feel here you are quite confident where you are. It's kind of like if I put genuine energy, it's no way to not come genuine energy. Why I'm saying that? Because for some of you, it's like, yes, I've done so good for so many, and look, I don't have this, I don't have that. I'm gonna tell you this. If you put a rose in the dirt to grow and bloom, that will be a rose, will not be a different flower, still a rose. If you put an orchid in a vase or how you call those things, an orchid will be there. Keep in mind that. Let's see here. What do we have for you, my lovely Scorpios, and how the things are? Glad to see all of you here. Of course, Scorpio, if you really enjoy the things I am bringing to the table, don't hesitate to subscribe, like, and share as well. Your feedback is very much appreciated. The hangman jumped from the deck, so I feel here the things you thought doesn't go the way they are, or it's kind of feel like a moment in time. No, the world didn't stop. Actually, many, many of you have done a lot of progress. So it's time to see the things from a different side. Or you starting to see the things from a different side. That's why happiness is a state of mind. It's not a person, it is not a thing. And Three of Swords underneath, Four of Cups, and Ace of Pentacles. Something here didn't move. Probably the way you wanted, because it was not what you needed. This is what you leave behind, which feels that a proposal or a thing which didn't really brought you happiness. And this Ace of Pentacles feels quite promising. It's kind of like, I told ya, if something doesn't move the way you want, pay attention. So the universe, if said, no, this energy is not gonna move, because Scorpio, I want you, for you, something better. You gotta pay attention. And sometimes feels harsh, the things when we are going through, but looking to that, we'll see. Here you are. Oh goodness. Scorpio, you are in the Emperor energy. No, you are not an Aries. Many of you may say, well, you call us the Emperor. Yes, you take the energy of the Emperor. You might have Aries in your chart, but I feel here the Emperor energy is you this week, taking action, being confident into the movement. And the Emperor is that stubborn person who kind of like, you know, if I said this, I gotta go. I will not take a no for an answer. Awesome. Nine of Swords, Nine of Cups, Chariot, look at you, and Five of Swords. It's like somebody here doesn't really believe that you're gonna do this. It's like you get out from the comfort zone. It's like somebody here want you down or want you on the lower level. And you actually step up even higher. And you say something that you will do. Yes, there's still certain worries out there. But it's kind of like whomever is here is not quite what they expect that you will do. Let's see here. Five of Swords, Page of Wands, Ace of Swords, and King of Wands. So will be a talk about some sort of action, but it's kind of like you will just have an idea of, oh, you know, maybe we'll do this. And the other person's like, I don't believe you are honest. And you just kind of like, watch me. Because you take the energy of fiery. The Scorpio I'm speaking here could have strong fire in the chart. For some of you, you are dealing here with the fire. But I see here that somebody here is like, doesn't believe. It's kind of like, oh, it's just talk. It's just chit-chatting. Nine of Swords, Magician. I feel here you could look into the energies, or you very much were struggling to believe in your own self. Magician can do it all, has all the tools for everything and anything they put their mind to. So it's kind of like, I'm not gonna be a follower of whatever somebody here is telling me, do this, do that. I will do my own reality. So Scorpio, I feel here there is kind of a side of you you never thought you have. Do you understand that, loves? And this week could be this month or following month, or as we move into Mercury retrograde and as well the full moon in Cancer, which is next week on the 18th. But I feel here this is by the full moon in Cancer, you take these actions. But somebody here doesn't trust or doesn't believe, or it's kind of like you, whatever you do, whatever actions you take into, it's more likely to see truly that you can do this. It's not like to show or to make a show or show somebody. No, I don't feel so. But I truly believe there is somebody here who's just like, yeah, I know you do that. And also, somebody here could tell you, let's do it together. And then they will say, oh, if you do it, it's okay, do it. They never had or never intended to be with you there. Let's see here. What's this? Three of Swords, Knight of Cups, and Four of Cups is the Moon. You knew whatever you put on the table over there, there was something not quite there. And the Hangman, Page of Cups. You know, I feel here this is you most likely of unable or not feeling ready or not feeling that you can do certain things. But I feel here clarifying this jumper, the Hangman by the Page of Cups is more likely speaking that Scorpio, you now forgive yourself that you procrastinate the things you did, and now you are giving you the chance to go through those fears, to conquer them, and move forward. And that's awesome. Stepping out from the comfort zone to get the things you want to. This could be at your work, this could be in a business, this could be in a connection with someone. Let's see the advice for humans. What's that advice that my Scorpios needs to see? Ten of Wands, Wheel of Fortune. Four of Swords. And Queen of Wands. Queen of Swords underneath. What I'm seeing here, Seven of Wands is the next one. What I'm seeing here, if you leave a person behind, that's a done deal. Was one-sided, you know that. For some of you felt for a long time that to get where you need to, gotta push hard, or to be very hard on you, or gotta do it like so much, like you know, strong. And now you come to realization that actually, the things gotta go in the flow and move with the flow. And with the Wheel of Fortune is to put the trust in there with this Wheel of Fortune. Speaking of taking the time and feel like, well, why certain things didn't really go the way it is? Because the universe, again, wants you on a new site. So for some of you, indeed, you step up and get out from the comfort zone and do what you need to do, even you're afraid if it will work or not. But it's kind of peace of mind, allowing certain things to go with the flow, to go the way it is. And also, somebody here might told you, Scorpio, that a person you were, they were talking behind your back. Somebody here behind your back done certain things or did or talked or and now you feel here's like, I gotta do a cleanup. around me. Yeah, absolutely. So, my loves, that's what I have for you. Allowing the universe to bless you. And whatever you are, there is movement. See ya, Scorpio. I hope this connects with you in a way or another. If does, let me know. Blessings. Namaste.